हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ संतोष एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ लिटरी माइंड। फ्रेंड्स, आफ्टर डीयू बीएड एंट्रेंस एग्जामिनेशन दैट वाज हेल्ड लास्ट मंथ, यू ऑल वर आस्किंग मी सर व्हाट वुड बी द प्रोसीजर एट इफ वी रियली वांट टू सिक्योर आवर सीट इन यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली बीएड। एंड द सेकंड क्वेश्चन दैट यू ऑल वर आस्किंग मी इन द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप वॉज related to the documents required at the time of admission. So all these queries will be dealt in this video, but please do not try to skip this video. Watch this video from starting to the end, otherwise what will happen, you will miss a lot of information, right? So now coming to the point, the very first thing that happens after any entrance examination is the availability of your answer key. So NTA will be releasing your answer keys. So from that answer key you can check your raw marks, and after that answer key the final scorecard will be released. Your answer key is challengeable. You can challenge any question if you were awarded no marks or negative marks for any particular question. But the final scorecard will be having your final scores. Got this point? And that final scorecard will be helping you to check your name in the cutoff list. That will be released later on by the colleges. Got this point? Okay. So you can check your cutoff in the DOE side, Department of Education side. In that side, you can check your cutoff. When all these cutoffs will be released, I will be telling you and all about this, that when they are going to release and all. And very frequently, you all were asking me even this question, that when they are going to release our answer keys. So frankly speaking, I do not know, but I can give you an expected date that in next 15 to 20 days you can expect at least, because last year even this had happened with us. So I can give you the expected date or dates only, because I am not an official of DO or NTA. Anyways, after that scorecard, you need to check your names in the cutoff list, because after that cutoffs will be released by the particular colleges. So you need not to, you know, get worried that where you will be getting all these information. I will be telling you, don't worry about it. But you need to check frequently the Department of Education site. Okay, so there you will be getting all kind of information. If any YouTuber misses anything, at least you can check your at your own part, right? So after that, the very important question comes, the documents required, because you will have to make your documents ready at this time only, because when the cutoffs will be released, you won't have any time to make your documents ready. So you can check here that the very first document that you will be required will be your scorecard. So I have shown you and told you about it, that you will be required the scorecard. So this was my scorecard, and I have told you that since my category was OBC non-creamy layer, but even then I had to take admission from general category in Maharshi Valmiki College of Education. I have told you the story that what had happened, what wrong had happened, I would say, with me. So anyways, that was a different story. So this will be the final scorecard that NTA will be giving you. So this will be required. Okay. You don't need to submit this scorecard anywhere. Let me clear this first. You need not to submit this scorecard, but your marks will be mentioned there automatically, okay, in the cutoff list. So this will be required. So since I was just telling you about it, okay. So the documents that you really need to procure is this, you know, provisional certificate. Provisional certificate is like this. So this is from School of Open Learning. I expect that you, if you are doing it from DU regular colleges, so your provisional certificate would be different. So you need to procure it from your college. They will be giving it to you. Okay. After this, the character certificate you need to procure. So character certificate would be like this. If you are from any other college other than DU, so like this will be the character certificate they will be giving you. So you need to ask it from your college, from where you have graduated or post graduated. Okay, so you will be asking, they will be giving it to you, and there will be the sign of principal and will be stamp of principal. Without stamp and without signature, please, because this had happened last year. Some of our friends had missed to collect stamp of the principal. So please do not try to do so. check everything. Your name is correct, everything is correct while they are filling the form. You need to check everything, okay? Some of the colleges get provisional certificate or character certificate computerized, printed, okay? But if your college is getting it to you in a handwritten form, so you need to be very much careful because there are chances of error, okay? So please check the names. If the name is correct, your father name is correct, everything is correct, okay? Otherwise, you are going to get in a serious trouble. After that, you need to have your graduation or post-graduation mark sheet. If you have done post-graduation, you need to have your post-graduation mark sheet or degree, I would say. If you have done your, you know, PG or graduation years back, so you need to have your degree. If you don't have degree, if you recently have post-graduated or graduated, you need to have your provisional mark sheet. So in the provisional mark sheet, there will be stamp of your college, and also with stamp there will be principal's signature. Okay? Okay, so these two things you need to be very much, you need to be careful about. Okay. After that, your caste, EWS certificate, minority certificate, if anything you have applied under these categories, if you have applied, so you need to procure these documents also. And for SC ST, I think they don't have any kind of limitation because their you know, old certificates even would work. But for OBC, they require latest certificate. For example, if it's 2021, so they, your you know, I would say your OBC certificate must would have been issued after 31st March. Got this point? So also you need to have an NCL certificate. NCL is non-criminal, OBC NCL. So have these things in your mind, otherwise you will be required to fill undertakings. I will be telling it later on. Okay, so all these things are clear, and there will be there also will be stamps, you know, when you will be having caste, EWS certificate, there must be stamps. But nowadays digital certificates are issued by the state governments or central government, so work accordingly, I would say. So if you lack by any certificate, for example, let's say if you are not having OBC certificate for a while, but if you are thinking that in next 15 days you can procure it, or next 10 days I would say, so you can, you will have to fill undertakings, and these undertaking forms will be issued by your college. So these forms will be like this, you will have to fill it, okay? In these undertaking forms you will be given 10 or 15 days, and in next 10 to 15 days you will have to submit your documents that you were not having at the time. Anything, for example, if you are not having provisional certificate, you are not having degree or character, but if you want to secure your seat, so you need to fill this undertaking, and you will be given 10 to 15 days of relaxation, and after 10 to 15 days you can submit these documents to them, okay? So after that, if you are not from let's say if you have done your UG or PG from DU, so you need not to have any kind of migration certificate. But if you have done your UG or PG from any other university, so you will have to procure migration certificate. So this is the migration certificate of DU, and for other universities the format would be different, but this is all about the migration certificate. So if you have done your UG or PG from different college or different university, I would say, so you need to have your migration certificate, okay? So these were the documents, I think, that you will require at the time of admission. What happened last year, the verification of these documents were done online. How? Online. I am not sure about it, whether these will be done online or offline even this time. Okay. But most probably if this happens in an online mode, so you will have enough time, and you can... but I would say that you procure all these documents at a right time, so that at the time of admission you do not hustle, you do not get into any kind of trouble. And also one thing, while you will be filling the undertakings, check your name and everything in a very fine manner, okay? Also, you will have to submit all these documents in online form. And how you will be communicating with the college after you have watched, for example, in the first cutoff list, you have seen that your name is in, let's say, MVCOE college. Okay, your name is in MVCOE college. So what will happen? You will have to log in your DU portal, and there you will have to select the MVCOE as an option. Okay, if you are a boy, so only two colleges would be an option for you, MVCOE and CIE, Central Institute of Education. But if you are a girl, there will be three or four colleges in the list, if you are not taking home science, then three only. Okay, so you will have to select particular college from there, and you will have to you will be asked to apply. So you can click on apply and you will be applied. So your email ID would be received by the college, and particular college will be mailing you. Okay, and they will be asking you for the documents if this goes online. Otherwise, if it is offline, then you will have to travel to the college, and physically you will have to make verification of your documents and degrees, everything. Okay, so this was all from my side, friends. Thank you to have patience and to listen me patiently, I would say. And this was all from my side. I hope so this small video was enough to tell you all about the admission procedure in University of Delhi. If any query still you have in your mind, feel free to ask me. This is my WhatsApp number, 8383018454. Okay, this is WhatsApp number. You can also, while if you want to join my Telegram group, let me tell you, Telegram group. Okay, so you need to message me here first, and automatically you will receive a message, I would say, and there will be the link of my Instagram account, also Telegram account. So you download Telegram app, then you can join our Telegram group. There are already 2000 plus students there, so you can join at that platform also. Okay, you all can communicate at the time of emergency, even if I am not available all the time. Okay, so this was all from my side, friends. I hope so that I was able to solve few of your doubts. If you still have any doubt, you feel free to ask me in Instagram, in Telegram, in WhatsApp, or anywhere you feel comfortable with. Okay, if I will have time, I definitely will reply. Otherwise, my SEP is going on. SEP is like school experience program. So I will be busy for the next 4 months, but definitely I will try my best to reply all you all. Okay, so thank you. Bye.